Thank you. for very, very hard. And together we say, this is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. I am about to receive the incorruptible, indestructible, eternal seed of the Word of God. My mind is alert. My heart is receptive. I will never be the same again. Never, never, never. I will never be the same again. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, you were not saying anything. I saw your mouth. You were not saying anything. Praise the Lord. Please come with me. Let us stand in honor of the Word of God. To Luke chapter 2, verse 10. Luke chapter 2. And together we will read verse 10. Luke chapter 2. And together we will read verse 10. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. This morning, the Lord is going to be talking to us on a sermon titled, Thank You, Jesus. What is the title? To lead us into the sermon, we'll just take this worship song. You are Alpha and you are Omega.
You are Alpha and Omega. We
glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Jesus has done for every one of us, because of the things that he's doing for us right now, and because of the things he has promised to do for us, even in the days, in the weeks, and in the years to come. So how many of us are really thankful for what Christ has done in your life? You are really thankful for what Christ has done in your life. And I prophesy over your life, the things of rejoicing, the things of thanksgiving will never cease in your life in Jesus' name. Amen. That is the strength of what I want for today. As you read through that Luke chapter 2 verse 10, it says, I bring you good news that the Savior of the world is visiting at last. So I'm saying to someone here today, your own Savior is visiting you and him today in the mighty name of Jesus. So the angel said to them, said, look, there's no need for you to be afraid. What I bring to you is good news. And by the way, great things are about to happen. In the name that is above every other name, I prophesy into your life. Great things shall begin to happen from today in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree in the name that is above every other name, the name Jesus Christ of Nazareth, even before the end of this year, you will receive a good news in the mighty name of Jesus. I say you will receive a good news in the mighty name of Jesus. Point number two, technical department, can you please put the points on the screen as you bring it up? I have finished with point number one, you are just bringing it up. Point number two, and please take as much notes as you can. Wonders are about to happen. When the birth of Jesus Christ was being announced, one of the things that was said in Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6, he said, his name shall be called Wonderful. Why is it that the name of our Lord Jesus Christ shall be called Wonderful? Because wherever he goes, wonders happen. That is why I'm happy to announce today that for someone here sitting, even before the end of this week, a wonder will happen in your life in Jesus' name. I say something wonderful will happen in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Philippians chapter 2, verse 9 to 10 tells us that this Jesus Christ that we are celebrating today is not just about gifts, it's not just about dressing very nice, it's not just about visiting. Said the Jesus Christ that we are celebrating today has a name that is above every other name. That as soon as you mention that name, every knee shall bow. Therefore, in that name that is above every other name, the name Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I decree into your life before the end of this year, something wonderful will happen in Jesus. Signs and wonders we are following him. When you study the book of Luke, chapter 7, verse 22, somebody came to Jesus and said, are you Jesus Christ? And he said to them, I don't need to answer you. Just look at the things that are happening around me. The blind people, they are receiving their sight. The deaf, they are hearing. The lame, they are walking. Even the dead are raised from the grave. That's why I have news for somebody today, that the next miracle is your own in Jesus' name. I said the next miracle is your own in Jesus' name. There is no one that goes into the presence of Christ genuinely and goes back the same way that he came. That is why I'm very happy for you today. That if you have come genuinely into his presence, you will return with a miracle today in Jesus' name. You know, when Jesus Christ was about to leave, the Bible said he pronounced into the life of the Christians, the disciples, they said, I will be with you till the end of time.
And then when you read back chapter 16 of that same encounter, he said, wherever they went, Jesus Christ went with them, and he established his word in their mouth. With what? With signs and wonders following. That's why I announce unto you this morning that because of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that we are celebrating today, signs will begin to follow you.
Yeah.
Wonders will begin to follow you.
Yeah.
Miracles will begin to follow you.
Yeah.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yeah.
But number three, this Jesus Christ, we are thankful unto him, not just because he brought us good news, not just because whenever his name is mentioned, everything bows, not just because wherever he goes, miracles are always happening. We are thankful to him because he is the only one that can solve all of our problems. I don't know the problem you are going through today, but one thing that I know for a fact is that your problem is not too big for Jesus. So I'm happy to tell your neighbor, your problem is not too big for Jesus. Why do I say so? In Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, the Bible says his name shall also be called a mighty God. He's not just a God, he is a mighty God. And in Luke chapter 1, verse 37, it says, With God, nothing shall. So I don't know what you are going through this morning. I don't know what it is you are struggling with in your life. But there is something that you have been trying to look for solution, and you have not received that solution up till now. I want to prophesy it to your life. I want you to rise on your feet. I just want to prophesy it to your life. You've been going through something that you have not been able to find a solution to. I don't know what that problem is. But Jesus Christ that we are celebrating today says, when you mention my name, every problem will disappear. Says, when you mention my name, everything that is spoiled shall be renewed. In that name that is above every other name, I decree into your life, every problem that has defined solution, it is disappearing today. You are healed in Jesus' name. Let me share another
in 1999. At that time, I was 2000. I went for a medical test. I think I've shared the testimony before. After I finished the test, a few hours later, I received a phone call. The doctor called me and said, come now, now, now. I said, what is the problem? I was summoned into the presence of the doctor. This was in America. She looked at me and said, I'm sorry. So is the case. This kind of problem, sorry, there is no solution. I look at my lady, this doctor has not heard of the name Jesus before. I went back home and cried unto the Lord. Say, Father, you said you can do all things. In less than 2 or 3 weeks later, the same doctor called me and said, go and do that test again because we are starting to see some things. So they went and did the test and said, there is no more problem. That Jesus that did it for me, that can overcome the cancer, the report of the doctor, that can heal the sickness that says has no cure. In that name that is above every other name, I decree into your life, every problem that has defined a solution, receive your solution today in Jesus' name. Every barren person here this morning, I prophesy into your life in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Receive your children in the mighty name of Jesus. Every one of you that the enemy has been tormenting, in that name that is above every other name, you are free today in Jesus' name. Why are we celebrating in Jesus? Next point. But the Bible says he is in full control of your life. You know, there are people that like to exercise control over your life. There are people that are even sitting far away. They are not even in Lagos. But they are using remote control to determine your life. But Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6 says the government shall be upon his shoulders. That the man Jesus Christ, the man Jesus, is going to be in full control of your life. That is why I'm prophesying one more time into your life today. Everyone somewhere that has been trying to control your life, from today their hands are broken in Jesus' name. Every door that has been trying to determine your future, in the name that is above every other name, from today you are released from their hands in Jesus' name. Isaiah chapter 44 verse 6. Isaiah 44 verse 6 says, I am the Alpha, I am the Omega. Beside me, there is no God. How many of you believe that there is no other person that can control your life? So you are going to be used your mouth and begin to prophesy. From today, Jesus is in full control of my life. That's what I begin to declare to yourself. From today, Jesus is in full control of my life. All other gods shall fail concerning you. Anyone that wants to exercise authority over my life shall fail in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus Christ is my Alpha. Jesus Christ is my Omega. In him alone I live. In him alone I move. In him alone I have my being. All other gods concerning me shall fail. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The Spirit is leading me that there are some of you here that know that there are people that have been messing around with your future. Whether it is in your office, whether it's in your family, whether it's in the spiritual, I want you to write on your feet. I just want to pray for you. You yourself know that there are people that have been messing around with your future. Maybe it's in your office, in your family, or in the spiritual, that you alone, you see them when you are asleep. You know they are trying to exercise control over your future. Father, I commit this your children into your hands. You said in your word that can the prey be delivered? Can the lawful captives be set free? Say yes, even the prey of the terrible shall be delivered.
in the name that is above every other name. Father, now in Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I decree into the life of this one, everyone that has been trying to exercise authority over their life against the will of God, I cancel that in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, he said, if the Son of God shall set you free, you shall be free indeed from today. It's not only because signs and wonders go everywhere he goes. It's not only because when you mention his name, mighty things begin to happen. We are celebrating him because he also can make a way where there seems to be. So I want you to look at your neighbor and say, God will make a way for you. In that name, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. If they do not release you into your full destiny, I decree they shall not make it to 2014 in Jesus. Everyone that is saying you will not reach your destiny, everyone that is saying the purpose of God for your life will not be accomplished, if they do not change before the end of this year, they shall be buried. That when things become so difficult, when things become so hard that you don't even know what to do, you are confused, you are perplexed. The Bible says this man, Jesus Christ, that we are celebrating, will just give you a revelation that will set you free. In John chapter 8, verse 7, it tells us the story of the woman. They've already declared that day will be the day of her burial. I'm sure you know the woman I'm talking about. They went to Jesus and said, Lord Jesus, they told us that if anybody commits adultery, the person shall be stoned to death. And as they were talking to Jesus, their stones were in their hands. They had determined that that woman would die that day. Thank God for the counsel. They said to him, Jesus, don't you have anything to say? After a while, said, yes, I have something to say. I have a counsel for you. Any one of you that has never sinned before, let him be the first to stone this woman. When they had that counsel, the Bible said all of them brought their stone and they went to quarrel. That's why I'm praying for somebody today. All those that are looking at your mistake, all those that are looking